Hey everyone, welcome to This Week with Racers 360. We have a special one for you today. At Racers 360, we're always scouring the internet looking for some great stories going on in the motorsports world. We came across an organization called Track Obsession out of the UK, and they have a really cool competition, a power to weight competition, where the two are mixed together and they see which car has the best ratio between the two, and they compete. 500 horsepower cars that weigh over a ton versus cars that have 300 horsepower less to see which one is the most efficient in terms of that power to weight. Now this week, we've got James from Track Obsession to talk us through his program, how they held the competition, and we're even going to give you some easy ways to reduce the weight in your car. So make sure you tune in through the whole video because we're going to have some great insight from James. So without further ado, let's get into it. So James, thank you for joining us here at Racers 360. We're really excited to have you. My first question is, what made you start the Power to Weight Shootout?
We started the Power to Weight Shootout because everyone talks about brake horsepower figures, and you know, big power figures from the engine is all well and good for pub talk, but when it comes to the racetrack, it's it's the power to weight figure that really matters. And we wanted to, you know, try and display that and get that information out there to, you know, to the general public to really consider, you know, the weight of the car and how that affects the car. So we started the Power to Weight Shootout, you know, to really, like I say, display that and measure that against other cars. And it's the second time we've done that event. It's worked really, really well. There's a lot of improvements been made to cars, you know, off the back of it. And it's also made for some really good competition from some completely different cars which you'd never match up to each other, which are generally really similar when it comes to the brake per ton figure.
Wow, that's so interesting to hear, and I can't wait to ask you what some of those changes were made to cars to help performance. So stick around, I'll definitely be asking James that question. But you had mentioned there at the end, you know, how some of these cars are competing that you never would have thought would be competing. So I'd love to know, what is the biggest surprise that you've seen so far in your Power to Weight competition?
The biggest surprise of Power to Weight Shootout was probably how close it was this year. I mean, you know, just on brake horsepower figures alone, I think there was about 200 horsepower difference at the flywheel between second and third place. But because of the weight of the cars, I think the actual brake per ton figure was one brake per ton difference between second and third. And, you know, it doesn't come any closer than that, but also, you know, it shows just how important weight is. So yeah, you have 500 horsepower car, but if it weighs, you know, a ton and a half or 1700 kg and you've got a little nippy Clio, you know, coming past you, you know, it just shows you how important the weight is to the car. So I'd say that's the biggest surprise of this year, is just how close it was and how much it shows you the importance of the weight of a race car.
Wow, that's amazingly close. And I can confidently say, for anyone driving a 500 horsepower car, nobody wants a little nippy Clio that's passing them on track. So what I'd love to know from your standpoint and your experience, how does the weight, or taking weight out of the car, actually help the car on the racetrack?
Yeah, so weight, like I said, really, weight affects the car in every aspect. Weight affects how you accelerate, weight affects how the car performs through the corners, it affects you under braking, also the longevity of the car itself. So, you know, the less weight, the less stress you've got under the engine, the less stress you're putting through the tyres, the less stress you're putting through the brakes. So everything's going to be more durable. You're going to get a lot longer life out your brakes, a lot longer life out your tyres, and especially in the, if you're going for long stints on the track day, or racing, you know, what we do in the 750 Motor Club, doing 45 minute races, you know, weight is really key to make sure that your tyres and your brakes last consistently throughout the whole race.
Wow, that's really interesting. I mean, a lot of us think of taking weight out as only helping acceleration, but to hear from your insight that it not only helping just under acceleration, but helping really corner speeds, braking, and even the longevity of the car, which is something that I don't think is spoken about as much as it needs to. It doesn't really matter if you're a club racer, doing HPDE style driving. If you're taking weight out, you are going to be preserving, especially those brakes. And I know we've all felt as those brakes start to wear, the pedal starts to get long. It's not a comforting feeling, really. So that's some great insight. So the way I want to leave off this part one interview with you is I would love to give our fans an idea on what are some easy ways to take weight out of the car.
I say the easiest way to take weight out of the car is, you know, first and foremost, just losing everything you don't need. You know, be it, you know, spare wheels, which is pretty much your, you know, most obvious one. You know, rear seats, but then going down into, you know, sound deadening, which you know, can sometimes get overlooked, but you can lose, you know, especially out of a modern car, you can lose sort of 10 to 15 kg out of a German car, for example. And then you can go a little bit deeper into like heater matrix, you know, window regulators, sort of cutting out some of the door panels. You know, you can do all that pretty much for free without spending anything. And then obviously if you want to spend a little bit more, then you can add in sort of plastic windows and fiberglass panels. But yeah, weight is, you know, although you might not see it in terms of like power figures, you know, weight is really gonna affect you on a racetrack. And like I say, you can do so much weight reduction for free if you're, you know, really turning your car into a track focused machine. Then you should be focusing on that first.
Wow, that is awesome insight, James. We really appreciate you joining us from the track over there in the UK today. Just perfect summing up of doing the cheap stuff first, or even the free stuff first. We've all seen those drivers spending thousands of dollars putting the latest mods on their car, and they just aren't necessary. Starting off with the basic, just getting out the spare tire out of the car, the body panels in your car from the inside, that's easy to do, and that's easy weight to get out of the car, and that's not gonna only help you in terms of speed, it's gonna help you in longevity throughout your track day. So this has been some awesome information. Part two, we're gonna talk about what are base model cars that you can get that start off with the best power to weight ratio. So if you want to learn more about that and other motorsports coaching tips, make sure you subscribe to our channel. Check out Track Obsession over there in the UK. Thanks again, they joined us, took some time out of their schedule. We really appreciate that. If you like this video, hit that like button. If you have any questions for Racers 360 or James at Track Obsession, leave a comment below and we will get right back to you. We want to help you on track, not only in terms of speed, but keeping you safer and making it cheaper so you can get on track more often. This has been our Racers 360 part one interview with Track Obsession. Make sure you tune in for part two.